Hello everyone. So a bit over a year from now, July 2024, we have the mandatory implementation of tethered caps within Europe. So if you're currently planning the implementation of these tethered caps in your filling line, feel free to ask us and discuss the impact of this implementation on your closure inspection machines. So I'm the responsible product manager at Hooft for these closure inspection systems. So feel free to contact us at tethered.caps@hooft.com and we will support you with any question you have.
Did you already make the decision on which tethered cap you want to implement on your filling lines? As you can see, we've gathered a lot of experience here at Hooft in the last couple of years with a huge variety of tethered cap solutions. Either symmetrical tethered caps, asymmetrical tethered caps, molded TE bends, slitted TE bends. We can support you with any question you have about the impact on the closure inspection system when implementing these tethered caps. So when talking about different inspection technologies and the impact of implementing maybe rotational asymmetric tethered caps, we have different systems available. For instance, the one camera vision system, which is not a 180 degree inspection system because we are inspecting round objects. We can only see around 120 degree of the closure sidewall. When you want to go for a more sophisticated and accurate solution, we advise you to go for the FineView cap solution where you have four cameras for a 360 degree all around view. Of course, these more accurate systems are also different impacted than the systems that already have a 240 degree blind spot. So when implementing these tethered caps in your filling line, the impact on your closure inspection system is not only determined by the type of closure that you're implementing, it's also determined by the inspection technology that you use. So when talking about inspection technology, illumination is of course an important factor. So we have transmitted light that's used to establish a shadow image for measuring the height of the closure, or incident light that's used to have a frontal inspection of your temper evident band. When combining these two types of illumination, you can still make the decision to upgrade your system from black-white cameras towards color cameras, so you can even find smaller defects. So when implementing tethered caps and you still have any questions regarding the impact on your filling line, contact Hooft. So when having four cameras, incident light, transmitted light and color cameras, you will still have a problem when implementing certain type of asymmetric tethered caps. For instance, for this closure, a loss of inspection accuracy of up to 50% is required to run this closure on your line. This is a problem that Hooft of course wanted to solve, and therefore we developed a special software to overcome the problem of non-oriented containers on your filling line. As you will see in the image, the evaluation method is kind of rolling out the closure sidewall. So when looking at the rollout of the closure sidewall, we're searching for a certain centering characteristic and therefore overcome the problem of non-oriented containers. When having this centering characteristic, we can evaluate the closure specifically for this angle of the view that we have on the closure sidewall. When building a kind of footprint, as you can see up here, histogram of the closure sidewall, we can first reject bottles when they're exceeding this teached-in histogram. In that way, we found a solution to not compromise on the inspection accuracy of a temper evident band inspection. Hooft knows how.